If we dumped a puddle of liquid nitrogen straight into the palm of our hand, how long do you think it would take for the skin to cool down enough to where the nitrogen could latch on and bite it? Now, in previous videos, I've showed you that you can take liquid nitrogen and splash it in your face or roll it off your hands with little to no effect. And that's because the Leidenfrost effect basically vaporizes the nitrogen into a gas, which shields you from the intense cold of this liquid. But what do you think would happen if we left the nitrogen in one place for a little bit too long? For example, what if we poured this into our hands and just let it sit? Now, if we were to take a little bit of this liquid and just pour it in the palm of our hand, but we keep our hand moving fast enough, you can see the liquid doesn't actually do any damage. It just skittles around, kind of like playing a game of air hockey, until the nitrogen completely evaporates. But what would happen if we stopped moving our hand and let the liquid nitrogen settle down and stay in one place for a little bit longer? Okay, so this is where I start getting a little bit more nervous. I don't want to stop moving my hand because I know what's going to happen, but watch this. If I do stop for a second, watch right there. You can see it actually instantly frostbites the skin. Let's do that again with a little bit more liquid. That's quite a bit. I'm just going to, whoa, you can see immediately it starts frostbiting me. And as it warms up, it disappears as quickly as it came. Now, to me, this feels like a little bit of a bee sting, almost like it got stung, and the pain lingers for about 10 to 20 seconds. You can see the skin is turning a little bit red there. It's not to the point of where it'll be a first degree burn just yet, but it would be if we left it exposed a little bit longer. Let's try a smaller bead here. Let that settle down. Boom, ooh. Okay, I chickened out. I don't really want to keep this going much longer. I'm gonna try one little bead and see if I can make it all the way through. This may not be the smartest idea, but I'm doing this for you. Go, there's a nice little bead. We'll let it settle down and, oh man, that kind of actually hurt. So you can see it's turned my skin completely white. As it warms back up though, it starts to fade. You can see this is taking about 10 to 15 seconds. Now I do feel a little bit of pain there. It is a lingering sensation. It feels like after you got stung by a bee, and you can see the coloration in the hand is a little bit more red. But even at this point, I wouldn't consider that a first degree burn. It might be an extreme case of frost nip, but I wouldn't expect that to blister up. You can see it only takes a fraction of a second for nitrogen to actually grab under your skin and start burning it. And the reason I say burn is because frostbite is actually very similar to first, second, and third degree burns, depending on how long you're exposed. I wanted to show you this reaction because I've done a lot of experiments with liquid nitrogen, and I didn't want you to get the impression that it was super safe stuff to play with. You can see that it will burn you, and it'll burn you very quickly. And it does hurt, and leaves a mark. Now you might be wondering what this feels like, and right now I have lingering sensations all over my hands as if I was stung by bees multiple times. There is a lingering pain in that part of my hand, almost like somebody's taking a nail and pressing it down into my skin. I get an itchy, tingling sensation that makes me want to scratch it. So if you do happen to get frostbitten, this is the way that you want to treat it. Get yourself a bowl of lukewarm water. You do not want it to be hot, and you don't want it to be cold. Just lukewarm or room temperature, and just soak the area for a couple of minutes until it starts to feel better. Then take a warm, dry cloth and press it to the affected area and just hold it until it starts to warm back up. Now, depending on the severity, you might want to go seek medical attention and see what your doctor has to say. So how long does it take for liquid nitrogen to freeze your skin? Well, according to my experiments, it only takes a fraction of a second. If you leave your skin exposed any longer than that, it's gonna start freezing the muscles, freezing the tendons, and you could actually get to the point where you freeze your entire hand solid, and that would not be a very good day. That's all I got for this experiment. I'll see you in the next video. Talk to you then.